spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I... She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again. Just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
I can't figure out. Odin wants to prevent Ragnar. But the Serpent's already been there and seen it. So hasn't he already failed?
Fate's a tricky thing, lad. And Odin's just arrogant enough to think he can get the best of it.
Fate is another lie told by the gods. Nothing is written that cannot be unwritten.
On that, brother, you and the Allfather may just agree. Even if he can't prevent Ragnarok, he still hopes to learn enough details to influence the outcome. Remind me later to tell you about the wolves.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Glovi's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Glovi?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I guess... I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you. Nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about them. Don't you?
What else would you say to her?
I'd tell her that we're both okay. Not to worry about us.
Atreus, I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I knew very little.
You're familiar with the tale of Skoll and Hoti, bringers of day and night.
Oh yeah, the wolf giants.
Aye. They were born of the arch-wolf Hrothgwitnir, a great nemesis of the Aesir gods. Odin captured them as pups and kept them in the kennels of Asgard to hold his foe at bay. But when the sun and moon grew mutinous and stood still, Odin put Skoll and Hoti to use. With his ancient magics, he cast the wolves to the heavens, and they began their chase. And long shall they chase, but not endlessly. For it is foretold that someday Skoll and Hoti will catch and devour their prey. And that day shall be Ragnarok, the twilight of the gods.
But Ragnarok is supposed to be Odin's doom, isn't it? Why would he set the wolves loose if it fulfills the prophecy?
Precisely the question, lad. It's always about control. The wolves determine when Ragnarok begins, and now he controls the wolves. A battle fought on his timetable is a battle he better stands to win.
Nicely done!
Another name. Rota!
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
I still can't read these.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. I can read these now. It says Muspahan, the Fire Realm, is the gauntlet of the sewer, sir. Like a magic glove?
Or a series of dangers.
We should go see sometime.
Our young god knows no fear.
Atreus, follow me.
Be right there. One more and we can translate those Niflheim runes.
Ugh.
suck.
Here, boy. Another one.
This one is Thrym, a frost giant king.
Correct. A cunning one as well.
Is that Mjolnir? Did he steal Thor's hammer?
Aye, for a time.
A lot of these seem to end with Thor killing them.
Imagine that.
Another name. Call.
Someone who loved the Valkyries enough to do this. I wonder. Perhaps the Queen?
Thank you. Lemire, why don't you tell us the story of the giant that stole Thor's hammer?
Happily, my boy. It involves your friend Freya, too, though I don't expect it's one she'd enjoy being reminded of.
The giant
was called Thrym. And he proved cunning enough to make off with Mjolnir while the thunder lummox slept. Sadly for Thrym, he didn't always think with his brain. Though he had robbed the greatest giant killer of his greatest weapon, he offered to trade it back to the Aesir in exchange for Freya as his bride. Now, at this point, Freya was married to Odin, and Odin, frankly, would have traded her for a sufficiently strong mead, but he saw an opportunity here. Thrym's palace was in Jotunheim, and only giants know the way. By agreeing to the marriage, they'd have to escort Freya back to their realm. So, Odin coerced Freya into using her Saethir magics to conceal her, so he could sneak along with her and infiltrate Jotunheim. When the hammer was produced as the wedding dowry, Thor revealed himself. He took back Mjolnir and wasted no time in smashing Thrym's skull, followed by every other giant present for festivities. The only thing that put a stop to it was Freya, who wanted no part of this massacre. She cast a powerful spell that hurtled them both out of Jotunheim with no means of return. Odin was livid, hoping that Thor's foothold in Jotunheim would become his own. And oh, would he ever revenge himself upon Freya?
What is the point of this story, Ed?
Well, for Thrym, the lesson would be to keep his priorities straight. For Freya, it's that doing good has a price. For Thor, it's that no object of power makes you what you are. And if what you are is the biggest butchering bastard in the Nine Realms, nobody can take that away from you.
Boy, over here.
Sir. Okay, that's going in the journal.
Done here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great. I wonder what happened to this ship's crew.
Oh.
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.